Hi, I'm Paula Platt. I'm the general manager of the Doc Tony Clinics.
And I'm Doc Tony. For the next 30 minutes, we're going to discuss everything you need to know if you're injured or involved in a car accident. Car accidents can affect you on many levels, financially, emotionally, so it's real important to know exactly what you need to do should you be involved in a car accident. So stay tuned and learn exactly what you need to know.
Doc, you've built such great clinics while focused on getting people better. Tell us what exactly happens to somebody when they're in a car accident.
All right, so when somebody's involved in a car accident, let's first understand that the human body was not meant to absorb being hit by a car traveling, you know, whatever, 30 miles an hour that weighs 4,000 pounds. So we're going to talk about a common accident. So what you're looking at right here is I'm sitting here in my car. This is the back of my skull. This is what you're sitting on. You're sitting on your hip bones, and you get rear-ended. Boom. That force that hits that car goes through that car, and it goes through you. So what it's going to do to your spine, it's going to first straighten it, then it's going to snap your head back, and then it's going to snap forward. It's going to do this violently, and it's going to do this abruptly. That's why they have those headrests in the cars. Those headrests are there to stop your head from continually going back. Before they put those headrests there, people used to get more severe injuries. They actually would become paralyzed because there was nothing to stop their head from going back, and they would actually tear their spinal cord. So people watching this show, it's imperative, very important, that you adjust those headrests so that your head is almost touching it. That way, if you're involved in a car accident, when you get rear-ended, your head travels very little. So that force that goes through that car, goes through you, it overstretches, tears, and ruptures your soft tissue. Now, the reason why that's so important is your soft tissue is what gives you mobility and stability. So let's talk about a common injury that people may be aware of, like a knee injury. You damage your knee, you damage one ligament, and that knee is prone to degeneration and it loses its range of motion. In your spine, you have hundreds of ligaments. You have so many layers of muscles. So when you have a car accident, you overstretch, tear, rupture the soft tissue that supports and gives stability to your spine. So it's a very serious condition. It's something that you never, ever want to just ignore.
Let's talk about the 14-day law. Why should we seek medical treatment right away?
Well, it's always important to seek care right away. In the state of Florida, you have a 14-day rule or 14-day law that states if you're not in to see a doctor after being involved in a car accident, you lose your benefits. How they came up with 14 days, I don't know. There's no medical books that state after 14 days, you're okay. But the bottom line is people tend to procrastinate or wait when they have an accident because people are tough. You have an accident, you think, hey, maybe this pain is gonna go away. My neck feels a little stiff, it's a little sore, but they'll wait. They have a tendency to wait. By the time they wait, it's now week number three, your benefits are gone. The insurance company doesn't have to pay. But they've done everything to inform people. This has been the law for a long time, for a few years now. So the bottom line is, people, if you're involved in a car accident, even if you're not feeling even any pain, you should always be checked out because you could have some injuries that only a professional, when he starts touching and palpating, ooh, now you realize, ooh, that's sore. It was damaged. And see, look at it like this. First, you can get micro trauma, like stress fractures in a beam, in a supporting beam. The roof looks fine. Then all of a sudden, boom, it falls down. Yeah, because it's been coming for some time. So it's imperative that you always get checked. You, in the state of Florida, you have 14 days. Always be looked at. Never wait the 14 days. Always get in before. But if you wait and it goes after the 14 days, you lose your benefits in the state of Florida. You know, Florida has the worst insurance laws, and we'll get to that. So soft tissue injuries, that's predominantly what happens when people are involved in a car accident. Soft tissue injuries, they require rehab. They require therapeutic exercises to reduce that scar tissue. My man Terrell, he specializes in that. He takes care of all the programs. He sets all my patients up on all their programs throughout all of my offices. Terrell, go ahead and tell them what they could expect should they be injured involved in a car accident.
So the first thing I like to do before I start a patient on any kind of rehab exercises is just to take the time to properly educate them on certain key elements that they may overlook in regular activities of daily living. Certain things like proper posture, which includes proper sitting, proper standing, things like proper bending and lifting mechanics, proper stretching. After we go through that and I get the patient to fully grasp the importance of those little things, I like to take them into an assessment. So there's where I go through a couple of just range of motion exercises, things, you know, just to see if they have any muscle imbalances or muscle impairments. After that, I like to take them, that's when we start into our rehab portion of what we do here at Doc Tony.
And the key thing is the scar tissue. is getting it back to being as. How hard is that to actually do? Scar tissue is not as pliable, not as elastic as the original tissue.
Right.
And when you have a lot of scar tissue left behind, that is the biggest culprit and the biggest problem, correct?
Correct. So that's why when a patient comes in that acute stage of healing, we most so focus on healing the scar tissue damage. So there we do the EMS and the ultrasound. After that, within the next 10 to 12 visits is when we transition them over to therapeutic exercises where we can start to increase range of motion, start to soften up some of that scar tissue damage. And there is where the patient actually starts to feel the best and get the most out of what we do here at Doc Tony.
And so that EMS and that ultrasound, EMS being electrical muscle stimulation and ultrasound, that's sending current and deep heat into the muscle. It helps bring in more blood, more nutrients, help facilitate the whole healing process.
Correct. And EMS, I kind of like to explain it to the patients as it's kind of working out without being in a gym. The EMS is actually used to contract the muscles without using any weight-bearing activities. So in the long run, you're going to strengthen those weakened muscles
right.
and help rebuild the tone of the muscle.
All right. Well, this physique's not coming from EMS. You are spending some time in the weight room.
No, definitely.
There you have it, folks. Right after dialing 911, get started on what you need and call the doctor that provides you with all your accident needs. That's me, Doc Tony, at 1-888-888-8863. And remember, Jacksonville, I'm more than a catchy number, I'm real.
If you want quality treatment, if you want professionalism, if you want to go to a company with integrity that stands behind what they say, then go to Doc Tony. When he say he's real, he's more than just a number, that's true.
Doc, tell us more about yourself. How did you become a chiropractor?
I grew up in South Florida. I was always into sports, always into outdoor activities. So as a teenager, I actually worked in a warehouse delivering physical therapy equipment company. My dad worked for the company selling equipment, and I worked for the company delivering the equipment. So at a very young age, I was exposed to a physical therapist, an orthopedic rehab facility, chiropractic offices, and it was cool. I liked it because I was always into sports. So I knew pretty young that I wanted to be a physical therapist, not a chiropractor. I wanted to go to physical therapy school. So when I was going to school, I was actually started out as a PT assistant, physical therapy assistant. And I was 19 years old and I was finishing up my last year of PTA school and then I was gonna go to RPT school. So, you know, you do a lot of bed transfers. I was working with a lot of, at that particular clinical, I was working with a lot of stroke victims. So a lot of times, you know, you can't always transfer people and lift them with perfect biomechanics. So me thinking I'm big and strong, I'm not gonna hurt my back transferring a patient. Much respect to nurses and people that work in that field. It puts a lot of stress on your body and it really is a very tense, hard physical job. But transferring patients is very difficult. So I hurt my back and I was hurting for 8-9 months. I couldn't do anything to get rid of this pain. I had sciatica ripping down my leg. It was excruciating. I used to actually sleep over a couch at night to separate the vertebrae in my spine. So if you could picture this, I would sleep over a couch to where I would take the vertebrae and separate them to take the pressure off the nerve root. And that was literally the only way that I could sleep. So I really got tired of the suffering. I didn't want to have back surgery because being a physical therapist, I saw a lot of people that had back surgery and they didn't look too good. Not to put down back surgery, but I didn't want to go that route, especially being 19 years old. So I went to a chiropractor. The chiropractor gave me an adjustment. The moment he adjusted my SI joint, this big joint in your lower back, which I come to find is the majority of the reason that people have lower back pain. The moment he adjusted that joint, I felt great. And you gotta look at it like this. Those SI joints, that's like the alignment of your car. If your car is out of alignment, I don't care if you wash your tires, oil it, you can do whatever you want. That car is not gonna drive straight until you realign it. Well, they gave me cortisone shots. I had a belt that I used to wear, pumped up all the way to give my lower back support. I was on anti-inflammatories, muscle relaxers. They could reduce the symptoms a little bit, but I'm 19 years old. I want to go back to lifting weights and being active. I was never going to be able to do those things. When that chiropractor gave me that adjustment, I knew that that's what I wanted to do. So I graduated from PTA school. A month later, I moved to Atlanta, Georgia, and started school to become a chiropractor. Graduated in 1993, and I've been a chiropractor ever since. Love it.
Doc Tony is here to tell you what you need to know today before you decide to have back surgery.
This is something that is wreaking havoc, especially in my profession. Well, you need to understand when you're injured, involved in a car accident, and especially when you've hired an attorney, now there's money involved. And follow close. I am not saying that all attorneys are bad or that all doctors are bad, but just like anything in any profession in our country, you have to be conscious and you have to be cognitive of what could happen, and people could take advantage of you. So you have to watch that. If you're going to buy a car, you're going to do some due diligence. You're going to make sure that that car is what it is. But oh, too often when people have a car accident, they just pick up a phone, call any number. They don't know the attorney on a personal note. They don't know the doctor on a personal note. There was a time in our country that everybody had a primary care. You knew who your doctor was. But now when you have a car accident, you're going to a doctor that you don't know, okay? And very often people, just to make money, greedy doctors and greedy attorneys will do unnecessary procedures to you, whether that's back surgery, whether that's injections, or whether that's overprescribing addictive medications. We can see that this, the effects that this has had on our society. Right here in Jacksonville, our first responders are crushed every day with people that are ODing from these drugs, and it's gone past the pills now to a whole other problem, which led to a heroin epidemic. This is all being caused, not the entire problem, but this is still being caused today, who people who have unnecessary back surgeries get prescribed these pills for a surgery that they never need because they are living in pain. They didn't get any treatment. They got nothing to reduce their real pain, nothing for the soft tissue, nothing for the scar tissue. These greedy doctors and greedy attorneys went right for what's going to pay them the most money, and that's going to be injections, that's going to be surgeries, that's going to be prescribing pills. Listen, people, never get a back surgery without getting a second opinion. You know, people, the most important thing is just to be with a doctor you can trust. If you trust a doctor and you know the doctor to be a good doctor, then this doctor is going to recommend whatever you're going to need. You know, sometimes you have an accident, it's good to go to a chiropractor. Chiropractors can render all the care that you need. Sometimes you need an orthopedic, sometimes you need a neurologist. We need all healthcare providers working together for the benefit of the community, for the people that are injured. What we don't need is greedy doctors taking advantage of the people in our community. That's the biggest recommendation, is make sure that the doctors that you choose, you know them, you've had a recommendation, you know them to be good guys, good women, good people, then in all probability, they're doing the right thing by you. And that's the most important thing. And if you don't have a doctor you can trust, call me, Doc Tony. We'll check you out, we'll take a look at you, we'll give you our recommendations. If you need surgery, hey, we'll tell you. If you don't need surgery, we'll tell you that as well. Believe me, every single day, not just here in Jacksonville, but in every city of America, people are being taken advantage of. They're being put under the knife. They're getting surgeries done to them that they never should have had, which is leading to an addiction. And it just doesn't affect you. It affects all of us. I mean, it's not just affecting the person who had the accident. It's affecting your insurance. People go on disability. This is affecting our society in many ways. And the only way it's going to stop people is do your due diligence. And if you are involved in a car accident and a doctor recommends back surgery, always get it a second opinion. I'll repeat again. If you don't have a doctor you can trust, call me, Doc Tony. We'll take a look at you and we'll give you our recommendations. Thank you.
We have someone watching this program. Doc Tony is just like you said. He's more than a catching number. It's real. And when you come to his office, south, north, or west, you can't go wrong.
Welcome back. Let's talk insurance. The most common questions that we have and problems is that when people come into our office, they don't know actually what they have as an insurance.
Right.
And they're surprised when they don't have rental coverage or getting their car replaced, and so then they're upset.
Yeah.
You know, what do we need to do to fix that?
Yeah, big problem, yeah. And you know, the worst time to find out, people, what your insurance is after you have an accident. So if you want to help yourself, protect yourself, pay attention to this next segment, because this is important. Because as I said earlier, accidents happen out of nowhere. You never know. And the worst time to find out that you have, you know, bad insurance is after you've been involved in a car accident. And it happens every day. So let's talk about what the minimal required insurance in the state of Florida is. So the minimal required insurance is what's called PIP, personal injury protection to $10,000, and property damage to $10,000. So that's all you have to have in the state of Florida. We're what's called at-fault state. It doesn't matter whose fault it is. It's your responsibility to provide medical for yourself. Other states are what's called a responsibility state. In other words, the person that caused the accident, they're responsible. And I said earlier, Florida has the worst insurance laws out of all 50 states. We're like 48, 49, 50. We're right in there. Your politicians are not looking after you. You need to look after yourself. So what does that mean? Let's give you a scenario. Let's say you're driving in your car. All right, Paul, let's say you're driving in your car and you have three people in your car. And I come across an intersection, I T-bone you, and you have no insurance. And all I have is the minimal insurance. So there's three people in your car, they're your kids, and you're uninsured. You have no insurance coverage at all. I hit you, I have the minimal required insurance, which is PIP, and I have property damage. So the only thing I can offer up to you is $10,000 in property damage for repairing your car, but you have absolutely no medical coverage. Now, let's say you sustained damage to your shoulder where you tore a rotator cuff, which is common in side collisions because the way the body snaps from side to side, it's not uncommon. It's very common for people to injure their shoulders. Well, you needed surgery to fix that shoulder. Well, how are you going to get that? So people, you have to make sure you have, number one, have insurance, and having insurance is not enough. You have to protect yourself and you have to protect others. Currently, over 50% of the drivers driving in Florida are either underinsured, that means they have the minimal required insurance, or no bodily injury coverage, or they have no insurance at all. So how do you protect yourself? You protect yourself, number one, by having uninsured motorists. This will protect you should you be involved in a car accident by an uninsured driver. And you should always have bodily injury coverage. In fact, you can't get uninsured motorists unless you buy bodily injury coverage. MedPay coverage. MedPay coverage supplements your PIP benefits, which pays only 80% of your medical bills and 60% of lost wages out of 10,000 PIP limit. Comprehensive. The coverage will pay for damages to your car that does not result from accidents. And it's not expensive, people. Listen, believe me, I hear these calls every day for years. To find out you've been injured in a car accident and there's no insurance coverage, man, it could change your life tremendously. So take the time. All you have to do is call your insurance adjuster or agent now, or look at your insurance binder, find out. A lot of them will have you say, oh, you don't want uninsured motorists, and they'll have you sign off on it, that you didn't want it. They offered it to you and you didn't want it, because the insurance companies are playing chess, not checkers. They're slick. They don't want you having uninsured motorists, people, because then you're covered, all right? They actually had you sign off on it. Call them up today. Make sure you have uninsured motorists. It's not very expensive, is it, Paula? What's uninsured motorists?
Yeah, uninsured motorists is anywhere from $4.50 to $7.50 a month.
I mean, that's to give you protection and to look after one another in the community. People have bodily injury. If you're an at-fault driver and you cause an accident, of course you want to look after the person that you hit. You know, we don't live in utopia. It doesn't mean you did something wrong. Accidents happen. What makes it wrong is when we're not looking after one another. That makes it wrong. And the insurance companies win day in and day out over that. And believe me, they're not looking after the people. They're looking after their bottom line, their dollars. Collision, people. If you can't afford to replace your car, have collision. But I want to talk about something very important. Why your claims can get denied. If the information on your at-fault claim, all the information is not correct. In other words, I'll give you an example. Let's say when you got your insurance, you said that you lived, on this side of town. On the north side of town, and then you moved over to the west side of town. You need to notify your insurance company, because if you had a car accident, they could deny your claim because you failed to notify them of your correct address. Let's say you got married. You weren't married when you got insurance, but now you got married. You need to notify your insurance company, or you can be involved in a car accident and they can deny all your claims because the information on your policy is not accurate.
Even when your child reaches a majority of driving age, most people will not list them because they feel like their insurance is going to go
right up.
But actually, if they have access to your vehicle, they can deny the claim.
Chess insurance companies are playing, people. So if anything has changed in your life, make sure your insurance company knows. Otherwise, should you be involved in a car accident, they can deny your claim, and this happens every day. Don't let it happen to you, folks. Make sure all the information is correct. All right, Jackson, what I want to talk about now is one of the most important things, and that's the team, Team Doc Tony. And see, that's what I put together. I'm blessed to have a great group of people that have worked for me. Some have been with me for several years. Some have been with me for the whole time that I've been open. And that's what makes Doc Tony so successful, is that I have a great team around me. So when you come to one of my offices, you're going to meet some of those team members. You're going to have an opportunity to meet them right here today, where they're going to be showing you exactly what you could expect when you come into the office as far as paperwork. Then we're going to take you through, show you a little bit of therapy, what exactly goes on behind the scenes, what goes on inside one of our offices. And again, my success is based, number one, on you, Jacksonville, for accepting me. And I love you and I appreciate you all. And then again, having a great team around you. I could not do it. I could not render the care solely by myself. So the success and the reason that we're able to give you such good care is a great group of people that I have behind me. And I love them and I appreciate them all. And I want to take the opportunity to introduce them to you. So get ready and enjoy.
We have 4 locations, and I oversee all the aspects of the office. From the time that you make that first call to our office, you would speak to me in most cases. And then I would guide you through the process of what's happened with your accident, what the situation was, and then get you connected to the closest location to you. What makes us different at Doc Tony is that first thing that we're going to do is going to be all about your health and your recovery. Because we have four qualified doctors on staff with over 90 years of experience. So they're going to make sure that they take x-rays for you, make sure that they process their examination on you and see what your injuries are. Once we process the injuries, then he's going to create a treatment plan for you, which we have state-of-the-art equipment, digital x-rays, we have therapeutic activities. You're not going to find a lot of that in one house, basically, in one clinic. When you come to a Doc Tony's clinic, you also are going to be part of a family. We take care of our patients as if we were taking care of one of our own. So, you know, when you come here, you should expect to be welcome, to be understanding of everything that you go through, the process. And so whether you have questions, whether it's in the beginning or in the middle or the end, that's what we're here for, to help you get your answers that you need and make sure that you're taken care of. Our primary goal for you is to take care of your health and get you back to where you were prior to that accident.
What's up, Jacksonville? Doc Tony. Have you noticed how many emergency room centers are popping up around town? A lot. It's good to have choices, but an emergency room should not be your primary choice with soft tissue injuries. You've been injured, you need rehab. By going to the emergency room, there's a good chance you'll have little to no money left needed for your rehab. Call the doctor you can trust first, immediately after your accident, at 1-888-888-8863. And remember, Jacksonville, I'm more than a catchy number, I'm real. Okay, Jacksonville, for the last 30 minutes, we've discussed everything you need to know about being in a car accident. Let me take a moment and review everything we've talked about in case I missed anything. First thing, insurance coverage. The only opportunity you have to protect yourself from a car accident is before you've had an accident. That's with proper insurance coverage. Make sure you have not only the mandatory coverage, but bodily injury, BI, and uninsured motorist, UM. Bodily injury coverage will protect the people that you've injured in a car accident, you being the at-fault driver. Uninsured motorists will protect you and your passengers against drivers with no insurance or they're underinsured. Okay, we also talked about what happens to your body when you're involved in a car accident, specifically a rear-end collision. That force that hits your car goes through your car and through you, overstretching, tearing, and often rupturing your soft tissue, your muscles, your tendons, your ligaments. This is the reason you feel pain if you've been injured. Soft tissue injuries are serious injuries because your muscles, tendons, and ligaments provide not only mobility, but also stability to your spine. So now that you've lost proper stability, combined with the inflammation, the swelling, it's possible that you can feel a variety of different symptoms, such as headaches, neck and lower back pain, or radiating pain into your arms and legs. These symptoms are all possible as well as others. You've been injured from that car accident. That's why you feel pain. We talked about soft tissue and how it heals with scar tissue. The problem with scar tissue, it's not as pliable or as functional as your original tissue, which can affect your range of motion and cause you pain. This is the reason it's so important, people, to be treated after a car accident. You want to reduce the scar tissue, therefore improving your range of motion, reducing the long-term pain, and helping to prevent osteoarthritis of your spine in the future. Very important. Look at scar tissue inside your body as the same as a cut to your skin. It heals in a similar way. You want to prevent unnecessary scar tissue. The better you take care of your injury, the less scar tissue you developed. We talked about and showed you treatments for soft tissue injuries. Rehabilitation is an important part of soft tissue injuries. It takes work, people, to get back to a functional life after a car accident. And often, even with rehab, it requires lifestyle changes and often an occupational change. All car accidents involve soft tissue injuries. Therefore, everyone injured in a car accident should be receiving therapeutic modalities and therapeutic exercises. Therapeutic exercises are needed to stretch and strengthen the injured muscles and ligaments. They consist of a variety of exercises. Therapeutic modalities can be anything from ultrasound to electrical muscle stim to a variety of other modalities. Therapeutic exercises and therapeutic modalities all have several things in common. They are non-addicting and always help improve the stability as well as the mobility of your spine. We all need to do therapeutic exercises. Everyone needs therapeutic modalities when injured in a car accident, everyone. Other treatments that are often done and sometimes necessary are the prescribing of medications, spinal injections, and spinal surgeries. Some of these procedures are necessary, but are often done way too liberal. All have one thing in common, they can potentially lead to an addiction to opioids. So they should be done only when absolutely necessary. Unfortunately, people, when you're injured in a car accident, greedy doctors and greedy attorneys always want all three: prescription for pills, injections into the spine, and surgery. As long as the liability coverage is there, you're getting all three, and very little, if any, of what you need, which is therapeutic modalities and therapeutic exercises. So people, if you're being treated for a car accident and this is not the focus of your treatment plan, and you're already on pills and you're already getting injections into your spine, next is surgery. This is the sad reality of what happens to people when injured in a car accident here in Jacksonville. And not just car accidents, other liability cases where there's money to be made. Greedy attorneys and greedy doctors do this every day. In Jacksonville, and people as a nation, including Jacksonville, we face an epidemic that is destroying lives. We've all been affected by the opioid epidemic. We all know someone. This addiction shows no bias. It can be your friend, your coworker, or your relative. It can be you. The opioid epidemic is a pure sign of greed. In fact, did you know in 1 year alone, 254 million opioid prescriptions were filled? That is enough to medicate every adult in the US for a month on an around-the-clock basis. In that same year, pharmaceutical companies generated revenues of $11 billion from opioid sales alone. And they weren't the only ones making money. The pharmacies and the doctors that did the heavy distribution, they were making money too. And the pharmaceutical companies, all along they knew these drugs were addicting. That's right, Jacksonville. All along they knew, and they did it all for money, pure greed. Here in Jacksonville, as a result of that greed, our fire and rescue units have been responding to more than 300 overdose calls per month, more than 10 per day. Every day we lose our sons, daughters, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, and friends. As a community, we need to do everything possible to control and stop this epidemic. Our city requires resources to help the people that are addicted and people. One thing for sure, we need to do everything we can to prevent more people from becoming addicted. We need to take a look at how people get started with their addiction. A lot got started from prescription medications, and a lot got started after receiving surgery that did nothing to reduce their pain. In fact, it actually gave them more pain. And a lot of people got started after being involved in a car accident where they received all three: pills, injections, and surgery that did nothing to help them. It was all done for money, pure greed. We need to be less liberal with prescribing these medications and do surgeries and injections only when necessary. Kids, listen up. You get injured playing sports or just playing around being a kid. Remember, kids, you can take these pills one time and become addicted. Pain is part of life. You get injured, you hurt a knee, deal with the pain. In fact, pain is your body's way of speaking to you, telling you don't turn, don't move, don't wait there. It's your inborn intelligence that God gave you as a warning signal. Don't take the pills, kids, ever. One thing for sure, Jacksonville, greed is destructive. And when you're injured in a car accident and you end up with a greedy attorney that refers you to his greedy doctors, they will destroy your life. And they're gonna do it to the next one and to the next one and on and on and on until we stop supporting them. Remember this, people, that settlement money is short money. It's not worth destroying your life for. It's time to end the greed, Jacksonville. Be conscious about who you call when you're injured in a car accident. In my opinion, you should always call the doctor first and call the doctor you know you can trust. That's me, Doc Tony. I hope you find this information useful, Jacksonville. Enjoy the rest of your day. God bless you all. And remember, Jacksonville, I'm more than a catchy number. I'm real.